a number of security measures that you can implement onto your computer system, and this will help keep you more secure. The first one that we are going to discuss is biometric measures. Biometric methods are methods that are unique to the individual. This is a major benefit because it means that nobody else can access your computer because nobody else has the same makeup as you. And what I mean by that is nobody will have the same iris, face, fingerprint, voice recognition. This information is unique to you and cannot be replicated. Passwords are a set of characters that are known to the person who is going to access the computer. For example, I know my username and password, but no one else should know this. Passwords that are strong are a mixture of symbols and characters, uppercase and lowercase letters. Your passwords should be difficult to guess if you are going to access the system. To a login system, there is usually a database with correct usernames and passwords, and when you type in your password, if it matches this, you are allowed access. So the two methods we have talked about so far is by having biometrics. This makes your access secure, but you can also have a strong password. The next method that we can use is CAPTCHA. That's CAPTCHA. And it's usually a method used to prove that you are a human being and not a robot. It's often used when registering for access or gaining access. You may see this in online voting systems, but you may also see this on pages where there are comments so that they can check that somebody is not a robot posting spam messages. Another type of confirmation is two-factor authentication. This is when you sign into an account, you may be given an email code or a text message with specific characters, and this has to be matched up in order to access the system. The last method we are going to discuss, which will also keep your computer secure, are automatic software updates. They're important to apply to your computer because we're human beings, and often we can forget to do this. If this happens, we leave our computers open to flaws and holes in security, which hackers or viruses may try to infiltrate. We enable automatic software updates to repair these holes, and it means that somebody may not access our computer without our permission.